Hi, welcome, welcome, welcome. I just jumped right into it. Let's do Cancer, Pisces. I just did Cancer, so now we're going to do Pisces. Okay. Hi, welcome, welcome, welcome. My little Pisces, my little fishies. This is going to be your raw love. It's going to be now until the 15th to the 31st. Okay. Woo-hoo. Exciting. Exciting, exciting. Oh, I got to stretch my leg a minute. All right, Pisces. Ooh. Earth and Air Dragon. And you're linked to the Royal Blue and Gold Dragon, too, because you're looking right at each other. So it represents the perfect balance between heaven and earth. Stay balanced and grounded. Ground your visions, too, and manifest. Make sure you have hope. Make sure you're dreaming. Okay? You're about to stand in your power. You're about to awaken your majesty. You're about to, it's like wearing your cloak of power. Somebody else had this, but this is, it's beautiful. Okay, stand strong. This is a big transformation that you must have went through, but you are in perfect balance. Congratulations, Pisces. Wow. Yeah, stuff's about to manifest. So your hopes, your dreams. So stay balanced, because you are. You guys would probably be feeling this power, and if not, it's going to kick in soon. Pisces. Yellow might be good for you too. I'm just seeing yellow bubbles, but got the King of Water. That's you coming. Coming in strong, coming in hot. You got the Messenger of Fire and the Nine of Fire. So stay strong. Look at the dreams, the lantern. Follow them. Everyone has dreams, right? Sometimes you gotta be big and brave enough to follow them. Way too many. One more for Pisces. I guess that's it. And you got the World. Alright, you do have the Tower at the bottom of the deck. I will clarify that for you. But you're in your element, right? You're about to deliver a message in this, or get one, and it's gonna be exciting. Whatever you do, don't give up. Alright, one door shut for a new one to open. So that's a completion, which is great, okay? Stay balanced, because this is a big transition, especially, I knew I felt it, especially with the World coming out, okay? The universe is, like, really doing its thing with you right now. I can feel the power. I don't see it, but I feel it. So if you don't have it yet, I'm like, I don't see it, but I feel it. Well, that's power. Tell me about the King of Fire. Oh, the King of Water, actually. And it was the Emperor and the Five of Cups. So I don't know if you're holding on to this or they're holding on to this. It's someone's holding on to something petty. It's like they don't even see the two cups behind them. And it looks like it's the King of Water. It looks like it's you guys holding on to something petty. Petty, unfortunately, like. It's like, yeah, see, with that Seven of Wands here, it's like fighting all different energies, fighting your demons. You know, it's a lot of, carrying a lot of weight right now. Some, not all of you. But it's like, you either have the energy around you of somebody that's holding to something petty, somebody that's frustrated, or it's you. Tell me about the Messenger of Fire. Whoever's around you does not look grounded, but it's like, you are. Tell me about the Messenger of Fire. So that's why it's telling you to remain. Look at that. It's stable right now. It's shaking like crazy. Messenger of Fire. Once again, it's that Seven of Wands. Alright? It's like, you won't need to battle anymore. And you know, it looks like it's looking right at whatever's petty. It's like, no need to argue, no need to fight. You stay strong, my Pisces. You could be dealing with another Pisces, but you need to stay strong. Tell me about this Nine of Fire. Follow your dreams. Have hope. Faith. Stay grounded. You got some challenging information, conversation, something coming at you. Looks like the truth is coming at you. Or you have to deliver the truth. Tell me about the world. It's like time to wrap up whatever needs to be wrapped up. Something needs to come out. You know, and it's the King of Wands. So again, very strong in the King of Cups. It's like the same energy. Very strong Pisces, Aries energy. And it's like my Pisces is about to get a message from somebody in very strong Pisces or Aries energy again. So you got them both twice. Two Aries, two Pisces. Truth's coming out. Tell me about the Ace of Swords. Truth is definitely coming out about a situation. But once it does, it's like a society, it's a belief for you to move forward with or without. Justice. Something's going to be balanced. I don't think you need to balance something with this person per se, but it's like what goes around comes around, and it needs to be balanced whether you stick together or separate or move forward or don't. Karma seems to be on your side. This is heavy energy around you. You must remain grounded. Tell me about this tower. High Priestess. Three of Swords at the bottom of the deck is... another Pisces, right? Scorp energy. But use your intuition here. You have a lot going on around you when right now you should be focused on you, your hopes, your dreams, your desires. So whatever this external energy is to you, see you later. Like, cloak it. Let it go. You got the power. Cloak it. Stand in your own power. Don't let somebody else's power overpower yours. I don't even think it's two alphas. I think it's just time to release whatever energy this is. Okay? Let me pull your best advice. Because it's very... they're not giving me much. Like, the Emperor. When I clarified the King of Cups, it gave me the Emperor. And petty energy. And then when I clarified the King of Wands, which is another Aries, it gave me the King of Cups. So it's not telling me much. You've got the Libra energy in here, but it's like the truth coming out. Something was unjustified. It's clear as day. But it's like, you're not fighting this energy anymore, but it's still around you. So I don't know if that's coming back. And it's like, don't bother fighting it anymore, right? It's like, you don't want to get thrown off balance. Like, you are balanced. You already got the truth of a situation. There's no need to dig into it, maybe, is what it's saying. So, your best advice, speak your mind and be confident. You know, balance your mental and emotional aspects. You know, be professional. You're brilliant, right? So, it's like, make sure when you're considering what this is, you're using your mental and emotional aspect of your being to make the right decision. King of Air, they're asking you to be very, so that was a lot more than I thought. They're asking you to stand in your power. You're very intuitive. I think you have a feeling of what this is. You got the Four of Water. you think you're going to miss an opportunity. Like, you're discontent, you're bored. But it's like, open your eyes to the possibilities. What's at the bottom of the deck? And then you got the Ten of Water. So you got some good energy coming at you, right? So it might be after this Tower, though. You're just going to have a conversation. But make the right decision here. I feel this being a good spread. If you guys are in a relationship or one starting, you are arguing, it looks like you're going to hash it out. You just got to stay strong while having this conversation. Got to stay grounded. It's like someone's holding on to pain, whether it's you or someone else, but something's going to be karmically balanced. And when I talked about the Tower, it gave me the High Priestess, which is another Pisces energy. So it's almost like mysterious, right? It's almost like I'm not giving you an outcome. Because once again, you're the Pisces. You're going to have this moment. It doesn't look like it's going to be bad. So don't get frightened. The biggest message for you in the next couple weeks is staying grounded. Stand in your power. You need to awaken some magic here. Don't let a certain pride get in your way. Like, use the good pride. Wear your cloak with pride. Make sure you're seeing something in an emotional way, in a mental way. That's how you ground things. Doesn't look bad. It looks complicated, but it doesn't look bad. I love you guys. Bye.